Today we're going to talk about how to eat right for your animal type.
Well, what?
That's right, your animal type. And when you eat in accordance with your animal type, from what I've seen, it can significantly improve health, improve weight loss, and just improve life in general. So the first animal type we're going to talk about is the wolf. Now, symptomatically, when the human body breaks down, it's going to have certain symptoms. And these are the symptoms that I have listed under the wolf type. And those symptoms are going to be, one, you're probably not going to sleep so great. Just like a wolf is up at night howling at the moon, you'll probably be right there alongside of them. Some of the other symptoms that you're going to have is you might fall asleep okay, but you'll generally wake up about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. You'll crave salty foods typically, or carbohydrates. You're going to feel tired. In the morning when you get up, you're going to be dragging your body out of bed. It's going to be laborious, laborsome to get up out of bed. You might want to hit the snooze alarm a few times. As you go throughout the morning, you might need coffee or some type of stimulant to get you going. After lunch, you might need a nap, or you might feel like you need a nap, like you just need to get horizontal for at least 20 minutes. Often in the wolf type, if they do get horizontal for at least 20 minutes, they'll actually feel a little bit better. So they usually use some type of stimulant in the afternoon as well, like coffee, tea, chocolate, candy, something, Mountain Dew, to get them rolling, and then that'll push them through the rest of the day. They will eat dinner. And then the interesting thing that happens in the wolf type, when do we see the wolf active? At nighttime. So as we get closer to the evening time, we then see the wolf now more awake, more active. And when the rest of the world is going to bed, the wolf is up again, howling at the moon. And when the wolf body type starts to break down, it's going to collect fat typically around the midsection. It will also lose some of its muscle tissue, so the arms and legs can start to become thin. Now, in the wolf type, when we look at the physiology and understand what's going on, we actually have a breakdown of the hormonal system. We have a breakdown of the hypothalamus gland and the pituitary gland, which is in the brain, and their communication with the adrenal glands and ovaries and pancreas. So we have disruption in those glandular systems. Those five glands are affected typically in the wolf type: hypothalamus, pituitary, pancreas, ovaries, and adrenal. So the food, the diet that's going to be best for them is the diet that feeds those glands. And the nutrients that are great for those glands are found, what do wolves eat? They eat meat, right? So not that you have to go out and be this ravenous carnivore, but in truth, the things that are going to be best to help the adrenal glands make their hormones, to help the ovaries make their hormones, to help the pituitary, hypothalamus, all that work right, are gonna be proteins and fats from animal sources, which are grass-fed beef, wild-caught salmon, coconut oil, avocado, are really gonna be some of the best foods that you could eat. Now, there's a lot more to it than this, but I'm just trying to give you the highlights. So in each one of these animal types, the idea is you have to eat right for that animal type because that's your physiology. And if you don't, your body will start to break down and then exhibit these symptoms. So the rabbit type actually should be having. So those are the three different animal types. Go ahead and click down here, take my animal type quiz, identify which animal type you are, and let us help you with a weight or health problem that you've been struggling with and wanting to handle for a long time. Thanks a lot for watching today, and I'll catch you at the next whiteboard session.